In today's video, I want to talk about the Voxengo CurveyQ. And also a big thanks to Voxengo for sponsoring this video. So let's dive right in. So this is how the Voxengo CurveyQ looks like on your screen. And the first thing you maybe notice is that there are no parameters. To create EQ bands, you have to double click on the free space here. And all you can set is the gain and the frequency left, right. There are no Q settings. So if you want to create steep curves, you have to bring these nodes closer together and kind of simulate it. And as you can see here, the curve itself tries to tell you how the result will look like and what kind of artifacts you create by using here a steep curve, as you can see, which is pretty helpful sometimes. So let's remove this. And if you don't want to create actually a lot of nodes by double clicking, you can switch to a freeform mode here where you can just draw in your desired EQ curve. And if you switch back, you can see we actually created a lot of nodes here. You can step in and change manually if you want. Also, if you deselect all these nodes here like this and hit here invert, you can invert the whole curve. You can just put it or do it upside down. And you can also use here the percentage mode where you can dial in just a small percentage of your curve or even invert it if you go negative. Okay. So this is pretty nice. And you can also switch here to a second curve if you want and EQ the first curve by applying a second curve. You can see here the first curve is actually also changing too. And maybe also use a third curve here to make some bolder adjustments. This can be helpful sometimes, but you don't actually need this to do this all the time, but it's possible. So you can apply curves to your curves. Okay, let's reset this. Okay, the next thing I want to show you is the visualizer. So we have a track here in the background and you can see also the visualizer here is displaying all the frequency bands playing at the moment. And what's pretty helpful is that you can go here to the settings button and you can change the visualizer pretty drastically. So for instance, you can change the measuring window here for the average time from basically a short window where you have all the peaks to a pretty long window where you get a more longer overview over your frequency distribution. So let's bring this back here, and you have also some settings here, some predefined settings. So we have chosen here rate average, where you can change the average time rate. You can also switch this to average default or average standard. I think it's 200 or 300 milliseconds measuring window, or you can set this to max. So you have only the maximum peak values frozen basically in your visualizer, which can be helpful sometimes. Or you set it back to rate average and create a second spectrum on top of this. And yeah, chose max on the second one, so you can see an average spectrum visualizer and the max peak values here in the background. So this is also pretty nice. What's also helpful is the slope setting here, where you can kind of skew the visualizer. So in most cases, or most EQs, like the Logic EQ, I think, you have a weighting here of 0 dB per octave. So something like this, a pretty steep curve, but you can't read it very well because it has no meaning to your ears. It's basically every frequency is equally loud, but that's not how our ears perceive audio. Our ears are more weighted like pink noise, and pink noise has a slope of 3 dB per octave, something like this. And you can see we are not pretty far off here. Maybe we need more high end here. And with this 3 dB slope, actually you can see everything should be Or if you have a perfect white noise curve, or actually we can show you this by going to static and match here and use a predefined curve, the pink noise curve. See, the pink noise curve is here pretty straight in this mode. If we change the slope here, you can see it changes too. But with 3 dB, pink noise is exactly straight. And it's exactly nice to actually analyze signals this way, because we instantly see here, as you can see at this point here, we need some frequency content in this region. Okay, we need to add something there. So, we're trying to match our spectrum curve to a straight line in this mode, in the slope mode. I think by default this is set to a 4.5 dB slope, which is more like a slope for radio productions, pop music and so on. But there's a whole universe behind that. I just wanted to mention this because it was pretty important for me when I actually bought the Curve EQ back in the days. I think the Voxengo Curve EQ was actually one of the first EQs that could spectrum matching. So for instance, I have here a track I created yesterday, and we can analyze this in the Curve EQ and just hit here this small button, static and match. And we get here some rows of spectrums. So we can use the current spectrum for my track here and take it. And now I can see it's frozen in time, basically. Can give this a name, maybe. My track. Or we can take it again. Or if you're not happy with the analyzing curve here, you can hit this settings button here and maybe change the measurement time here and take it again. And now we can say this curve is something we want to apply something to. So we hit apply to. And then we need a second spectrum, basically, and we can use here a predefined curve, a pink noise curve. You can see here also the line in the analyzer. And we want to say this is our reference curve. So we hit reference. And all we have to do now is hit this small button here, match spectrums, and you can choose between 10 EQ curves, or you can use 60 EQ curves. And you can see we have a pretty wild EQ curve here happening on our track now. And what this does is basically the EQ tries to EQ our signal so that it matches the spectrum of pink noise. So we can close this down here, and then we can use the functions down at the EQ and dial in a certain percentage, or even can invert the curve completely. So we can use this to basically nudge our whole spectrum weighting in a certain direction. We don't need to apply it full 200% wise, just a small percentage to bring everything in the right direction, right? Then there's always here, you can use multiple spectrums. You don't need to use predefined curves here. You can also analyze a second track or a third track, and then you can apply then all the spectrums from different sources to your current material. So let's imagine you have a big project and you need a special sound design, and you need maybe a lot of EQ bands. And inside Voxengo Curve EQ, you can just add one note here. Then go here to save CSV. And you can save a text file. And we call this my curve here. And then you go to the Explorer, you can just open this up with the text editor, right? So it's just some numbers. And you can see here the first column is basically the frequency, and then followed by the gain. So you can insert here, for instance, 120 Hertz and 5 dB gain, or maybe 300 Hertz and 4 dB gain. save and load this again into the curve queue here. And you can see we have now added two bands. Okay, so that's pretty helpful actually if you need to insert a lot of EQ bands. But we can also go a step further with this. So for instance, maybe go here to Google Spreadsheets, and I already named this here C3 Harmonic Series, right? So what we want to do is we want to create here EQ bands for the harmonic series, starting at C3, which is our fundamental frequency. And I think C3 is exactly 131 hertz. Can see this also here in the top. 131 hertz. So we can type this into Google here. Exactly like this. And then we need to format this also to integer or floating values here. So all we have to do now is basically insert here some kind of function to doubling the frequency or to multiply the frequency with the row number. So we take the first number here, which is 131, and this is A1. And then we use here a dollar sign because we want exactly this cell absolute referenced. And then we multiply this by the row number of the current row here. So we have basically at this row here, we have this number times 2. And here we have times 3 and so on. So let's hit return. You can see here it's 131 times 2 is 262. And when we just duplicate this here or drag this down, you can see we get all these numbers here, which is basically the value in A1 multiply the row number. Okay, so in the second row or in the second column, we type in 0. We want 0 dB gain, and I show you why. Just drag this down. And all these values here need to be in the format of floating. So we need some points here, floating points in there. Okay. So all we have to do now is to export this to CSV format. Download this. Okay. And then we have to make some adjustments to this text file because it's not in the right format. So we have here all these commas we need to turn into dots, and we need to remove these symbols here. Okay, so let's do this. At first we want to remove this this dot here, so let's put in a dot and replace it with nothing. Then we take this comma 0, 0, replace the dot 0, 0, and then we remove here these symbols with nothing, and that should be good. So now we have frequencies and 0 dB gain. Just save this here. Then we go back to the curve EQ, and then we load the exactly this file. Okay, and you can see we have now a lot of bands here in the curve EQ. And one neat feature of the curve EQ is that you don't need to track actually these notes here. Just hover over the current note, and then you use your mouse wheel to apply gain to this note. And this is pretty helpful because you don't actually change the frequency accidentally when you're dragging, right? So like this, you want to drag this up and then you accidentally change the frequency. But when you use the mouse wheel, you only apply the gain. So let's go back here to the state. So this is something you can save here. It's exactly helpful in many cases where you need an harmonic series EQ, right? And then you can dial in here some frequencies. So we have here, I think I'm using noise. Okay, just use this noise here and can see. And then you can use these, all these nodes to transform your sound or use it for sound design. You can create a lot of these CSV files and can import it into Voxengo Curve EQ and then save presets for it. So it's pretty helpful actually in some cases, not all the time, but in some cases it's actually pretty helpful. I hopefully gave you a nice overview over all these Voxengo Curve EQ features and some inspiration what you can do with it. So if you found this video helpful, then please leave a like, leave a comment if you have some questions, and maybe subscribe to the channel and maybe also on Patreon if you want. So thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.